Father, we thank you this morning. We worship you because you are God. These are your children. We have come into your presence. All power belongs to you. Don't let your children leave your presence the same. Your word is about to come. We have entered the month of complete and the month of freedom. Today, let every burden that your children have carried, lift it for them today in the name of Jesus. Let any water that have gathered together to cover them, Lord, today let there be a divine separation. Visit your people who have said. You have done some before, and I know you can do it. Because 1,000 years is just a year for you, and a day is just 1,000 years for you. Speak to me, God. Those who are listening to me on the YouTube, those who are listening to me on the Facebook, those who are listening to me, those who are here, let your countenance and your face shine upon them. And not my lips, let my mouth be a pen of every writer. Let me speak your mind. Devil, listen to me. You know me and I know you. But I am not coming by my name. I am coming by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the one who overcame you over 2,000 years ago. I use that name to pick you, Your Excellency, Holy Spirit, the Archangel, Holy Angel Michael, take control. And at the end of the day, God, the name will be exalted in heavy places. We bless you, Father, for answering prayers. Jesus' name, shout a big amen.
Amen.
Sit down in the heaven place.
Oh, amen.
God gave me a word to somebody the first Sunday of the month of October.
When you are not saying
and I believe that after the message, somebody's life will be transformed. This is the month of complete. This is the month of freedom. But there's something that you have to know. Before things shall be complete in your
life,
there's some ingredients you have to know before your freedom will be sure. Let's go back to the Bible. John chapter number 6, verse 1 up to 15. John chapter number 6, verse 1 up to 15. I read the King James.
King James.
After these things, Jesus went over the Sea of Galilee, which is the Sea of Tiberias. Then a great multitude followed him, because they saw the signs which he performed on those who were diseased. And Jesus went up on the mountain, and there he sat with his disciples. Now the Passover, a feast of the Jews, was near. Then Jesus lifted up his eyes and see a great multitude coming towards him. He said to Philip, "Where shall we buy bread that this may eat?" But this he said to test him. If the Bible is for you, underline. This he said to test him. For he himself knew what he would do. Verse number 7. Philip answered him, 200 denarii worth of bread is not sufficient for them, that every one of them may have a little. One of his disciples, Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, said to him, there is a lad here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 small fish. But what are they among so many? Then Jesus said, make the people sit down. Now there was much grass in the place. So the men sat down in number, about 5,000. And Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, he distributed them to the disciples, and the disciples to those sitting down, and likewise of the fish, as much as they wanted. So when they were filled, he said to his disciples, gather up the fragment that remain, so that nothing is lost. Therefore, they gathered them up and filled 12 baskets with the fragment of the 5 barley loaves, which were left over by those who had eaten. Verse 14. Then those men, when they had eaten, when they have seen the signs that Jesus did, said, this is truly the prophet who is to come into the world. Verse 15. Therefore, when Jesus perceived that they were about to come and take him by force to make him a king, he departed again to the mountain by himself alone. Amen.
Amen.
The topic of my message.
Verse 780.
How you can make the impossible become possible.
Senia, wait me. I am the any hono. I'm an me.
Amen.
Amen.
How you can make the impossible become possible.
Nase said the ubet me ama de e din no abeye bete. Amen.
The passage that we read.
Yeah, I can kaye no.
It's about Jesus.
Na Yesu.
Who went out doing good.
Na oy ko abonti se oye papa.
Preaching the gospel.
Na oka nyame asem.
Telling the people to change.
Na oka chi o mse womu satura.
Because the kingdom of God is at hand.
Se nyame ahini na aben.
And after preaching to them, he began to do a lot of miracles, signs and wonders. Those who were sick were healed. Those who were dead arose. A lot of signs happened. And because of the signs and wonders that is following Jesus Christ, the multitude outside there heard about Jesus. So those who were sick, those who were in prison, those who were in bondage, those who were in curses, all of them ran to Jesus to have their liberty from every captivity, from the disease they have been there for years. So when Jesus saw them coming, he marveled. So he began to teach them the word of God. He healed them. He broke the broken hearted. And those who were in the spiritual prison were set free. Before they opened their eyes, it was 3 days. And the man in that, well, 5,000.
Now,
and wherever you see a man, you will see twice of a woman, and twice of children. So if men only are 5,000, then imagine the woman would be 15,000 or 10,000
plus.
And the children will be uncountable. These people came to Jesus. And when Jesus saw them, though he had them spiritually, but physically, Jesus had the compassion.
Yesu ehu won emobo.
And he saw in his heart that they were so hungry. So they should feed them. So he called Philip.
Into your friend Philip.
He said, Philip.
I said, Philip.
How can we feed?
Now, yes, we are better than Yesikadi at Tuaduanyam and Crawford Bibi.
We don't have money.
Yenisika.
And even this 5,000 men.
Inti Mema and Pimu and Numimpo.
The bread that we'll buy for them.
Aduanya de Bemono.
Everybody will get a little.
Ubiabena Kakraka.
And it will be good that they have not eaten at all.
A yes, so many decra.
Amen.
Amen.
And Bible says,
Achronis say,
Jesus asked him to test him.
Yes, I can't wait at the son.
Because he himself is God. And he know what he will do for them. Shout amen.
Kase amen.
So, one man called
Andrew.
He went to Jesus. He said, Jesus.
Yes.
There's a young man here. When he was coming, her mother bought him 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. That is all what we have it here.
Amen.
Amen. And Jesus said, bring it. Amen.
Amen.
And when they brought it, he commanded the disciples. He said the people were so crowded. Let them sit down. Let them sit down in groups. And Bible said it was so. I am preaching unto you. How you can make the impact
said the obey to me ama dear any ho no
to become possible
abeye the ewo ho.
And after that
na eno achi no
Jesus took the bread and the fish.
Yesu efa abodo no ne enam no
and he gave thanks to God
da onyame ase
about the bread
ewo ebiane no
and he gave to the disciple
no o de ma asuafo no
and he ordered them to share
no o share won se o mo nche.
And Bible says
na chiro ne se
the food they ate and they were so satisfied. And the remaining is about 5-7 baskets. So when the multitude saw the wonders that Jesus did, they said, this is a rare man of God. He is the prophet coming to this world. So Bible says Jesus knew their heart that the people want to took him and put as a king by force. So he ran away. One, how can you feed 5,000 or 25,000 people with 5 loads of bread and 2 fish?
This is
impossible. It cannot be done. Shout a big
amen.
Even just one person, this bread, he cannot survive even a day.
Amen.
Amen. But it was possible. For some reasons that I am about to let you know.
Amen.
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 One. If you are going through a situation that it seems impossible.
Ah.
There's some ingredients that you have to apply. First of all, see Jesus as your master. See Jesus as your Lord and your Savior. See Jesus as your wonder person. Shout a big amen.
I say amen.
Because the people knew what Jesus can do. But he doubted him. Amen.
Amen.
If you are a child of God,
we are
Jesus knew everything that he would do for you.
Yesu nimnia obeye ama wunyinara.
The problem that you are going through,
how are onemu?
He has the solution.
Ono ewo nsa no no.
To solve every problem for your life.
So obeye bibia ama wabrabo.
But sometimes he will test your faith.
Obeso ujidie nsu ahwe answer.
Amen.
Amen.
Sometimes he weigh you whether you are capable for that miracle. Amen.
Amen.
So Jesus always tests his people. He wanted to know whether they believe that he is God. And he can do everything. Shout a big
amen.
So first of all, let God be your everything.
Manyame enye obi biara.
Let him be your sources of your income.
Mane enye bibiara obetumi di anye
sika. And second,
ne to su mienu.
God does not use bigger things to do bigger things.
Onyame onfa adie kesie enye ade kesie.
Amen.
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 Two,
ne to su mienu.
Put this in your mind.
Fa eyi se wadwe mu.
That don't despise the little thing that is in your hand.
Adiketuana ekuta ono embunu abomfiewo.
Amen.
Amen.
They are people in life.
Abrabomu bebre wohwa.
They were waiting to get billions before they start business.
Omo twenso menya sika mpim ansa na omo bibia se.
They are people in life.
Bebre ewa abrabomu a.
When they see small thing, then they begin to fight it.
Omo hu adiketuwa bia na omo ohu popo.
A seed is a small thing. But when you put it in the ground, it will germinate. And after the germination, you see that it bears fruit in it kinds, in millions or thousand folds. Amen.
Amen.
So don't despise your little beginning. Don't limit your life. Limitation is a hindrance of prosperity in your life. Limitation is a hindrance of impossibility to turn into the possibility. Andrew and Philip, they limit themselves. They were thinking about money. But they don't know that Jesus is more than money. Shout a big amen.
I say amen.
So second, don't limit yourself. Don't disvalue yourself. Whether you are educated or not. Whether you are from a poor family or not. What you need that see Jesus as your master and your savior. And the little thing that you have, something miraculous will happen. Shout a big amen.
I say amen.
So Bible says,
actually,
they brought 5 loaves of bread
and
2 fish. Is it an insult? Amen.
Amen.
I don't know what was in the mind of the disciples. Whether they want to test Jesus or not.
Some person saw Jesus here, Anna.
Or they came to themselves that he can do everything, so we have to give to him.
Amen. Amen.
You see, God take the foolishness of this world to confine the wise.
Enioma, for a ewo we are saying no nya Jesus, nyame ofa no de.
How cost of this blood?
Ebodo kakra yi.
The thing that you don't value. That's what God will use to do miracles.
Amen.
Amen. Her mother bought this bread.
Ni mama to sa abodo yi.
Not for the older person but the younger.
Na o de ma kola no nye mpenifo no.
For him to eat.
Se onko di.
Imagine the food.
Ke sa aduani ani kita no yi.
Amen.
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 So God always come into your life.
Nyame eba wabra bom.
If he want, if you want him to take the impossible.
O pese ni a eni ho no offer.
Then value what is in your hand.
Na yes, e se won sem no wasom no bo.
Even if it is just one coin.
Se eye coin po na e won sem
that you have.
Eno na wo.
Jesus will take it.
Yesu befa.
Amen.
Amen.
Don't wait to get a huge amount of money before you pay your tithes.
And twen so benye sika puduo bebere asa na obetua won to susudu.
Don't wait to get money before you come to church because you don't have offering.
Men twen so benye sika bebere so asa na waba sori.
One peswa that you have.
Sika peswa na wo no.
God can use it to make the impossible become what? Possible.
Nyame ebema eno mpo abei amane ni ho na
amane. Shout a big amen.
Ka say amen.
And the third one.
Jesus
took it.
Yesu ojeye.
Amen.
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 It means any problem that you have. The little thing that is in your heart.
Kituana ikuta wono.
Surrender it to Jesus.
Chaimu ema Yesu.
And leave everything to him.
Na fabibia ema no.
Amen.
Amen.
The fifth one that you have to know. If you want to make impossible
become
possible, Jesus took the bread.
Yesu efa abodo nu.
He did not did anything. He raised his hand
heaven,
and he gave thanks to God.
No da nyame ase.
He said, Lord, I thank you for this bread.
Emasa abodo yi.
It is small.
Ayewo.
It is very small.
But I
thank you.
But
that it can feed everybody.
The
fifth thing that you have to know. Anything that comes in your hand. Don't refuse to appreciate God in it. People don't thank God for the little thing that they have. If you want the impossibility, then possible. The little thing that you have, give thanks to God. Shout a big amen.
Say amen.
Shout a big amen.
Say amen.
Thanksgiving is the key to open the unlocked doors.
Aseda ene beti miye buye adanya amua tutu nina.
Prison door can open. Through thanksgiving.
A fear say upon be pie abra or danya miasi.
Never be ungrateful to God.
Men ye bonuya ewanya mieni.
There are people, they don't thank God for everything.
Baby woman danya miasi ewa danya mieni.
They were expecting big gifts to come.
Omo pompa se ake see beba.
That's why we are still having that impossibility in the Christian.
And
if you know his God,
so when you say, oh,
then the little, thank God for it.
Amen.
Amen. They are men of God who want to help God. So when their congregation is very few, because of the comparison, they will go to medium so that they will win souls, and at the end of the day their life was in danger. Amen.
Amen.
God does not see the multitude. What you need is that the little thing he gave to you, give thanks to him. Amen.
Amen.
The small business that you have.
Hello.
The small business that you have
created,
give thanks to God.
Amen. Amen.
The singing room that you are staying,
singing room na watino,
thank God for it.
Me say,
amen.
Amen.
Don't wait for you to get self-contained before you thank God.
And can you say when you self-contained, say what
the kiosk that you are staying,
kiosk no kura odemu,
thank God for it.
Me say, danyamia si, say wanye baby.
If you want impossible,
say what person ni any hold,
become possible.
Because
the moment you thank God, it motivates him to do more.
That's
why people who don't know how to thank people, you will never get it more. But somebody bless you,
And
you always thank him.
Now
he wish he would do it every day. Bible says, enter his gate with thanksgiving. You cannot thank God and your life will be the same. Jesus took the blood.
Yes,
thank God. The Lord, I thank you that this blood has been multiplied. Amen.
Amen.
And the sixth one. After he gave thanks, he called the disciples. Give unto them. And he ordered them. Share it. This five load of bread. This few fish.
He
gave to them.
Or the mawon.
Say share.
Check.
Amen.
Amen.
If it is I and you, we will thus ask Jesus, are you mad?
Meanwhile, Rebecca said, ah, yes,
Amen.
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 One thing you have to know. Why they are about to share. You know, people were stronger than others. So people get and others not get. So the main thing that Jesus did. That let them sit down. Amen. The moment you sit down, you become powerless. Amen.
Amen.
Your legs stand for power. When you sit down on the floor, you are limited to everything. You become humble. If you want God to turn impossible, become possible. First of all, humble yourself. Amen.
Amen.
Humility will turn the impossible to possible. Jesus said, let them sit down. Amen.
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 Because God exalt the humble. And the plow.
He
bring them down. Amen.
Amen.
Look at your neighbor, tell person, humble yourself. You want your life to change? Then humble yourself.
He
said, let them sit down. And all the men sat down. Because if they were standing, they were so hungry.
No, oh, come on, the one.
The strongest. Get the blood.
The
weak people cannot get it. He said, let everybody sit down. Amen.
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 Two. When you sat down, it makes things easy. If you want to turn impossible, become possible. Orderliness is the key. Where there is no order, there is confusion. Amen.
Amen.
A church that there is no orderliness. Everybody can do anything. Orderliness is the key to turn the impossible to possibility. Amen.
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 Where there's no order, where there's no discipline, there's no way the possibility turns to possible. Impossible will not turn into possible. Shout a big amen.
Amen.
Discipline your life. Amen.
Amen.
If you want God to turn the impossible, He take your will away.
You pay if you
say sit down.
I said trance.
And they sat down.
No more trance.
In groups.
Amen. Amen.
If I carry this phone,
me fa a phone.
I say it's a gift. Somebody come and take it. You see people who run. And I know somebody will fall and somebody will step on it. Everybody wants it. But if you are sitting down, there's no way. Confusion will come. So orderliness is the key.
And no, and yes, to
turn the impossible
to become
possibility. Shout a big amen.
I say amen.
He gave the bread to the disciples. He said, share it for them.
Or say, check my one.
Amen.
Amen.
If you want to turn the impossible become possible, do whatever that you can do. Leave the rest to God. And He will make impossible.
No, or not, I be money anyone.
Become possible.
I'm an abum.
As He was sharing it,
Abraham won a channel.
He gave to a disciple.
Or the man, a swear phone.
It's a share.
Or some munche.
So what they know that they were share.
No woman, you say, or much.
So they took by faith.
Omo the GDS.
Trying to breaking them for them.
Now, Omo a
channel. And as they were sharing,
now Abraham won a channel.
That thing was increasing.
Now, Adiana,
amen.
Amen.
In life,
Abraham,
leave everything to God.
Jaidi Akanoma Unyame.
Stop worrying yourself.
Hello.
There are people, they have think the whole night. They could not be able to sleep. They were thinking about their finances. They were thinking about what they can do to live. Then you are killing yourself. Do whatever that you can do. Leave the rest to God. Because He will make the impossible become possible. This month of October, don't based on your own strength. If it is just 30 minutes prayer, pray to God. And leave everything to Him. The disciples, after they collected the blood, they just do whatever they can do. It's a share. Amen.
Amen.
If you leave everything to God,
so
do whatever that you can do. The rest is not your problem. They are Christians. They want God to do magic for them. God is not a magic God. Amen.
Amen.
It's not a magic God. Magic.
Oh, he's not a magic God.
Amen. So, leave everything to Him. That is your problem. If you can solve, then solve yourself. But if you can leave it to God, the small business that you are doing, before you see, that you become big company. All the Babylonians that we were hearing, they start with a little. And by faith,
that
increase. Leave your problem and your burden to God. If you don't take time, the little that you have, people will just confuse you. Don't wait to get big money before you buy a land. Don't wait before you get money before you build a house. The little that you have, the little that comes in your hand, use a little, and you can buy a land. Because with God, all things are possible. As a pastor,
says,
Paul planted.
Paul.
Apollo watered.
Apollo ebeguso.
It is only God that increase. So increase and multiplication is not from any man, but it's from the above. So I do whatever I can do to my strength. Then I leave everything to God. And in His own time, He will make everything impossible become what? Possible. Why are you stressing yourself?
I don't know. Titi, hi, hi.
1,000 years is just a day for God. You always think, have you got a solution? You always cry. Have you got a solution? Leave everything to God. Do whatever that you can do. Leave everything to God. And the God that you are serving, but the faith in you, he will turn impossible become possible. Don't limit yourself. Make sure you discipline yourself. Make sure you obey the instructions. Because they sat down. After they sat down, miracle happened. If there's no orderliness, there's no way. Miracle can happen. May God bless you. This month, let the orderliness, discipline, be your portion. Don't limit the little that you have.
Sit
and thank God. That God, I thank you. That now I'm a billionaire. Why you are having just 10 Ghana? But that faith, God will turn impossible. If you can thank God for the little that you have, then He will multiply it for you in thousandfold. Don't wait to get more before you thank God. What is in your hand? One day a woman go to Elisha. He said, your colleague, pastor, a prophet, is dead. If debt,
I say, oh, nipa, yes, of who are the
he said, what do you have?
I didn't know.
I have a little oil.
I said, me, what oil?
God always take the little that you have.
I mean, or jig it one hour.
The little time that you have,
and break a crown,
he'll take it,
and
he'll multiply for
no,
you.
Man, I be.
May God bless you.
May
God honor you. In Jesus' name.
Oh, yes,
amen.
Amen.
Just close your eyes. Father, I pray for your children. We have come before your presence. Turn the impossible become possible. Those who are sick, they were taking a medicine. That's what they are doing. Use that medicine to heal them.
Amen.
Any challenges that they were going through, because they have obedience in your word, they have sat down. We have humbled ourselves. Lord, turn the impossible become possible. You did it for Sarah, Hannah, Joseph, and this is our time. We bless them in the name of the Father, that you are turning impossible become possible. They were living here as a victorious. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, shout a big amen.